Now, we've had the controversial MIQ system for nearly 2 years. Let's take a look back. Our borders close in March 2020 to anyone but New Zealand citizens and residents after our first COVID case in February. The next month, all people entering are required to go into MIQ. 18 facilities are opened. In June, new MIQ hotels open in Rotorua, Christchurch, Hamilton and Auckland. A month later, MIQ opens in Wellington and police are introduced after security breaches. The Defence Force is deployed in August and charges are introduced for some users. In October, the allocation system goes live. Travellers required to have an MIQ voucher before flying. January 2021 sees the introduction of pre-departure tests for all arrivals, except from low-risk countries like Australia. The vaccine rollout begins in February. MIQ workers get their jabs. April marks 1 year since MIQ became mandatory and quarantine-free travel with Australia opens. It's suspended 3 months later. The Delta outbreak moves the country to alert level 4 in August and community cases are accepted into MIQ. In September, a virtual lobby is added to the MIQ booking system to manage high demand. November sees the MIQ stay for arrivals reduced to 7 days, followed by home isolation, and that's changed to at least 10 days a month later with the emergence of Omicron. The MIQ system has caught thousands of COVID cases at the border and played a major role in many of the domestic freedoms we've had during the pandemic.